The unveiling of Bright House Network Stadium here in Orlando. It's Texas, the sixth-ranked Longhorns, taking on the UCF Knights. And a moment ago, we were in Jordan and team, enjoy yourselves. It would almost be impossible not for them to enjoy themselves in this atmosphere and down in the middle of it all. For Central Florida, David, they built this stadium in basically a year. And it's amazing some of the projects that go around, not only in college football, but professional sports. And UCF built a building in one season, and here they are in their brand new home.
Well, they brought it. They brought the stadium online on time and under budget. We don't see that very often.
I'm from New York. You never see that.
Not in the Apple.
Hunter Lawrence will kick off. And a yard deep, it will be Emory Allen. And he is waved back into the end zone by Darren Baldwin. And look. On third down to the outside, Israel, and a drop by Sergio Joaquin. So three downs and out goes Central Florida. Let's take a look back at the kickoff. Danny has to be impressed by the first two downs. It's third down and a long eight. McCoy over the middle, and that's a first down completion. Nate Jones finds a soft spot in the UCF zone. The quarterback of Texas, are you ready for all this pressure? And he said, Coach, I have planned all my life to be the quarterback at UT. And it's easy when you hand the ball off to Jamal Charles to be the quarterback at UT. Here goes Charles to the outside. Inside the 20. Into the red zone go the Longhorns. Charles stepped out at the 19-yard line. Joe Burnett.
Every down back for the Longhorns.
McCoy spreads his team out an empty set on second down and nine. Only a three-man rush. McCoy buys time to the near side, and it's Jamal Charles. Quarterback in the eye on third and two. He gets the call. Stuffed at about the 10-yard line. Marked down, boy, right at the first down. Play clock is down to zero. It's a fake. Up the middle goes Jordan Shipley. He has a first down if the play stands. The play clock was at zero. I'm not sure even if the UCF sideline realized it, but if the play clock tackles against NC State, the 12th play of the drive for the Horns. Third and goal at the six. McCoy pumps. Has some room. Tucks it under. Comes up short. It'll be fourth and goal inside the 19-yard field goal. Bailey, an inspirational story for Texas. A former walk-on that was just put on scholarship before this season started to give the Horns the lead. And he has got it. Israel now checking off. Plenty of time on the play clock, but third and a mile. They have to get back to the Citrus Bowl to pick up this first down. A great throw, though. Kamar Aiken makes the catch, and he is right at the marker. It looks as if they will be giving him a first down spot. A couple of big play opportunities in the second half. That time stands in against the blitz, delivers a strike, and here's another one. Rocky Ross.
A year ago, number three in college football.
Israel on a keeper. First down, UCF. And let's go down to five that Israel has engineered to this point. Goes play action, stands in, and delivers a strike to Smith. Inside the 10. Knocked out of bounds inside the 5. They'll mark him at about the 2-yard line. It's first and goal Knights, a gain of 24. UCF spreads out Texas on first and goal at the 2. A shotgun for Israel. Inside. Touchdown. Kevin Smith. There's a flag down on the far side. We'll have to check the penalty. The Bright House is bedlam for now. Touchdown drive. The point after from Torres is good. Going to see in a moment. Second down and 5. McCoy traps to Charles. Has running room. And just about. Chris Obanaya is now in as the tailback. Third down and 3 for Texas. Swinging one out wide open is Obanaya. Flares out of the backfield. A very efficient drive for Colt McCoy. He goes empty on first and 10. Slants one underneath. Swede makes the catch. Charles in the backfield. McCoy sneaks it. Has the first down with no problem. You mentioned Colt McCoy's footwork and inner wide receiver. Second down and short. Charles tries to get the corner. The Knights string him out, but not back. And now it's Chris Obanaya in the game on second and goal at the 6. McCoy to the air. Slants one over the middle. An easy touchdown. Nate Jones got loose on a slant. Colt McCoy on come in. A good 2 hours before kickoff. A 14-play, 73-yard touchdown drive. Bailey's Texas extra point at their own 40-yard line. Back to the ground, the crease for Kevin Smith. Maintains his footing and has a first down into UT. And it was a heck of a first quarter with a 15-minute lightning delay as a part of it. Kyle Israel almost intercepted. A 47-yard field goal attempt from Michael Torres to try and tie the game. And the kick has the distance. He's got it. From 47 yards out, we're tied at 10.
And the Swede just to create a replay situation. He was overthrown.
Second down and 10. McCoy tries to escape the rush and cannot. That should go as a sack. That's all the way down here in Orlando now from Edmonton. And it sets up third and 11 on the sack. Here comes the pressure. To the outside, McCoy tries to beat it and cannot find Lima Swede, a sophomore at UCLA. Third down and close to 10. Israel completed a third and 14 earlier for a first down. This time, Kamar Aiken was... Antonio Wallace had a sack against NC State 2 weeks ago and needed to come up with the sack there. And now it's Chris Obanaya up the middle for a gain of 11 and another...
High and tight.
Well, they never stop coaching. McCoy over the middle. Again finds a soft spot. But he has a much larger role in the offense this season. McCoy now 14 of 17. And make it 15 of 18. Again, it's Jermichael. Charles up the middle. First down and then some. Lost the football. Charles fumbles it inside the three. Who has it at the bottom of the pile? He was smacked as he fell towards the goal line and the ball popped out. UCF thinks they have it. And they do. Your screen, that's our way this year to illustrate timeouts. So both teams have all three timeouts here in the first half. And it's the backup quarterback, Michael Greco, who fumbles the football. Greco is a mobile left-handed quarterback, a sophomore from Fort Lauderdale. And we were told by George O'Leary they wanted to get him in the game at times. This is the first opportunity he has in the game. And the first play run by Greco, he coughs it up. CF's defense to get off the field. McCoy with time. Buying himself some more time under pressure. Stays on his feet and then goes down. The pocket finally collapsed. Travis Timmons and Rex Hill combine on the sack. And it looks as if again. And Bailey's kick, no good. Another his last five, facing third down and a long three. Ruth Kelson has come on to replace Griffin. Underneath, there's a should-have-been completion for UCF. Three receivers for the Longhorns. It's a five-man rush. Ball batted at the line, and McCoy simply knocks it down. Once again, central team. Israel over his last six. A tip ball intercepted. An easy walk into the end zone for Brandon Foster. 33-yard interception return for a touchdown. That agreed to bring it in to secure the football, and an easy touchdown the other way. Ryan Bailey's extra point is good. Texas takes the lead back. He's now joined in as co-defensive coordinators at Texas. The two architects of Desert Swarm at Arizona. And again, they bring pressure. Rashad Bobineau comes on a blitz, hits Israel as he throws. Here comes the pressure. McCoy over the middle finds Cosby again. And Quan Cosby somehow sneaks out. That's why I asked. Most would probably say the winner of that game gets the leg up, being the Big 12 title game, and it'll be a favorite. McCoy again underneath. This time it's Nate Jones for a first down again. Colt McCoy, 20 of 27, 151 yards, and a touchdown. On second and 10 to the outside. Quickly makes the catch, tackled in the field of Texas. And they will leave Ryan Bailey out on the field. Bailey was out to attempt the extra point, so there's no need for even a personnel change.
Well, and I think this is a good move by Mack Brown. Make it a two-score game. Don't get the crowd involved. Take advantage of the turnovers that you created late in the second quarter.
So what amounts to little more than an extra point attempt from the right hash is a 19-yard field goal shifted to tight end. More of a pass-catching tight end. But Mack Brown is a fan. McCoy again uses his feet. scrambles out across the 45 to the... Here's a down and distance that an offensive coordinator loves. Second down and two. Charles breaks free. Breaks another tackle. Deep into UCF territory and stays on his feet. All the while Charles on the bench. Three-man rush. McCoy steps up, short hops it. Intended for Cosby.
And you can see
42-yard field goal attempt. UCF got a 47-yard field goal in the first half from Michael Torres. Plenty of leg for Bailey. And it down and eight. A four-man front for the Longhorns. They pinch a linebacker up and show blitz. Here they come, a delayed blitz. Israel stands in, delivers to the outside. Well, that might keep Kyle Israel in the game for a bit longer. Kamar Aiken not only makes the catch, but then gets drilled out of bounds and flags come out. Well, this could turn into a 30-plus yard play with the penalty added on.
Personal foul. Late hit out of bounds, number 7 of the defense. 15-yard penalty, first down.
Third down conversion. That's the first completion in quite some time for Kyle Israel. First down. Running room for Smith. Gets to the outside. Kevin Smith. Touchdown. They mark him out at the 3-yard line. He leapt from the 3 and looked to be inside the pylon. Kevin Smith's coming to the sideline. The entire offense is coming to the sideline.
Open the 3. They have to get a touchdown. And Smith is on the field to the left of Israel. They go right back to him.
Up the middle. He's in. Touchdown, Central Florida. And that time Smith made sure. And it's a one-possession game early in the third quarter. And for the first time in a long time, the crowd. Michael Torres' extra point is good.
Offense's speed at linebacker really helped.
Here comes the crowd on 3rd and 5. Play clock down inside of 5 seconds. A five-man rush. McCoy can't beat it. Flags down. Boy, the Texas sideline is livid. They thought it was passing.
Get your hands on
it. Kyle Israel had a huge third down conversion on the last Central Florida possession. A possession that resulted ultimately in a touchdown. Looking for a third down completion here. A wobbly ball intended for Ross. And that one looked as if it came out going sideways right now. He'd say, I would go over and worship them. No guy on my team would have any idea who they were.
At the very least, a hug.
Jamal Charles breaking tackles and picks up a first down. An empty set for the Longhorns. A four-man rush for UCF. Broken up. Darren Baldwin, again, the true freshman, jumped the
record. A whole heck of a lot about Kevin Smith, but scouts have taken notice. He's only a junior, so he still has another year here at Central Florida, should he choose to come back.
Israel to the air, underneath, and it's Rocky Ross. First down. Right back to the ground. Smith makes a nice move in the backfield and gets the edge. He's at the 35, all the way down to the 31-yard line of the Longhorns.
And occupies multiple offensive linemen.
Both Loki and Franco Camp in the middle, both on the Outland and Lombardi watch lists, and both had 4.0 GPAs last spring.
Quarterback draw. Israel can't get free. Scouts Inc. draft board for the spring draft. Third down and 12. Here comes the blitz. Good job by Central Florida to pick it up. To the outside, Kamar Aiken got tangled. Be a punt or go for it.
I don't like it.
12.
I don't like it here. I think you give up too much field position if you don't convert.
Israel. Deep for Ross. And it's intercepted. What a break for Central Florida. And now the official.
But the bigger mistake was George O'Leary. I think you play field position, especially with a wet field, still raining lightly.
I completely agree. That was not the right move to go for it on 4th and 12.
Downfield taking a shot for Nate Jones-McCoy, and that's intercepted by Joe Burnett. Central Florida gets it right back.
Spectacular interception by Burnett.
Israel on a keeper. Gets outside. That was no quarterback slide. He's close to a first down.
Trips to the top of your screen for the Knights. 1st and 10 right at midfield. And now it's back in the hands of the franchise back.
He's making moves. Kevin Smith breaks free. Inside the 20-yard line before he's hauled down. Ryan Palmer save.
In. 110 rushing yards for Central Florida this half, and they're back in the red zone. Here's Phillip Smith inside the 10, leaping down to about in the third quarter. Third and goal inside the one. Smith stopped short. Now what?
Third down from the 2-yard line. I don't like it, but again, you know, it's a non-conference game. O'Leary rolling the dice.
And he brings Israel at the goal line. Does he get in? Well, he makes us look like dopes with that decision. Touchdown. Kyle Israel ties the game early in the fourth quarter. And you certainly...
Torres with the extra point. It is good. Texas down by a point at midfield. A four-man rush just about gets to McCoy. Again, he buys more time and finds his man again. Unleashes him inside. Third down and close to two. To the ground. Obanaya breaks a tackle and picks up a first down. It's Oklahoma winning in 1978. First and 10 for Texas. A tipped ball. What a catch on the outside. Like inside of 11 minutes to go. Obanaya in the game as the lone setback. McCoy sneaks and has it. Wide receiver Lima Swede.
Texas may use fourth down in this drive as well.
They rush only three. It's a screen to Nate Jones. Brought down. Well shy of the first down after pick Arda. A 40-yard field goal attempt by Ryan Bailey to give Texas the lead once again. And he is perfect. Ryan Bailey, the junior that was just put
25-3 at half.
A big third down conversion opportunity here. Third and a long four. Israel buying some time, tucks it under, flags down as Israel spins out short of the first down. Moses Sr., Donnell Neal, first and 10. Play action. McCoy being chased. Lets it go down the sideline. Shipley's got it. First down deep into UCF territory for the Horns. Third down and 6. A tipped ball out of bounds. Blaine. 37-yard attempt for Ryan Bailey. And he is good once again. Shoe to go flat tire. There's a pit crew on the UCF sideline working on Kevin Smith's cleats. It's third down the yard.
Maybe another keeper.
Yes, Israel to the outside. Can he get to the sticks? He can and more. Lost the football on the way down. It somehow stays in bounds. Is that a fumble? Or is Israel down by contact? The officials seem to be marking it as a recovery for Texas. Waiting a long time to get the official word. It is Texas's football. Maintain control of that recovery before going out of bounds. That was dicey. On first down, flags down. This is a free play for Texas. Does it look like Central Florida jumped in the neutral zone? And here goes Jamal Charles to the house. Touchdown for the Longhorns. A 46-yard touchdown run.
The cost.
A 2-point conversion attempt now for the Longhorns. No good. It's all two down territory now for Central Florida. Israel steps up, hit, that's a fumble. It's loose and recovered by UCF. Patrick Brown was able to come up with the loose ball.
And, you know, what was that? That was not a classic Texas performance.
There goes Charles with the first down. Lost the football. He fumbled it. It's picked up by UCF. How is that possible? And then a flag comes.
With an onside kick.
Kyle Israel. Back to the air, to the outside, the catch made. Sergio Joaquin down to the 15-yard line. It's stopped. Israel goes to the outside, wide open. Here's Joaquin, and he's out of bounds. Plenty of time on the play clock, down to 11. Israel might be changing the play. Texas shows blitz. Here they come. Israel has time, dumps it over the middle. It's caught. Into the end zone for a touchdown goes Kamar Aiken. 35 seconds to go. Then UCF would still be in a position where they needed 2 touchdowns. But now they have a chance to go for 2 and cut the lead to 3. Israel pumps. At the goal line.
But they have a shot. They're still alive. You want to get this ball up in the air. Give your kick cover team a chance to make a recovery.
Jake Howard lets it go. It was loose for a moment, but covered up by Texas. Looked like Brandon Foster at the bottom of the pile comes out with the loose ball.
It looked like a pretty good...
In Orlando, a UCF, UCF chant goes up. They appreciate the effort. Fought win, Janine. Thanks very much. George O'Leary's team certainly has a lot to be proud of. But it's a moral victory as Texas wins it 35-32.